A big thanks to Bernhard for sponsoring this episode.
Hey Pitmasters, what is up? Today I'm taking over the show and actually I'm getting an assignment from the Pitmaster himself. So I have no clue what I'm doing today. The only clue I have is that the Bernhard is over there and that's about it. And I think I can take it.
I want you to smoke it and fry it and don't mess it up.
Okay.
No pressure.
Yeah. Oh, no pressure.
It's easy.
Yeah.
But don't mess it up.
Okay. Well, what kind of steak is it?
It's just a $300 Wagyu steak.
Okay. One more time. What to do?
Don't worry about
it. No. Tell me again. One more time.
Smoke it, fry it. Good luck.
Okay. This is the biggest steak I've ever cooked in my entire life, but also the most expensive one. So I'm a little bit scared, but I'm just gonna go ahead with it. I'm gonna clean it up a little bit with a paper towel, and then it's ready to get smoked. I'm gonna use the Bernhard flint, and I got this heartbeat sensor on my wrist, and my heartbeat is already racing because I love this device, and it's so easy. When you see me on the screen, it's gonna be an easy video because I'm a lazy guy. I like lazy stuff, and this is the perfect lazy machine. So I'm gonna check the pellets, and well, it's quite empty. I'm gonna use some hardwood pellets, and I'm gonna fill it up. And I don't need much, because we're only going to smoke a steak. So I'm gonna close the lid, and I'm gonna set it to 140, 148. Alright, as you can see, the Bernhard is smoking and it's smoking like crazy. And it's not on temperature yet, it's only 21 degrees. But that smoke, that's good smoke. That's really precious. So I'm gonna lay it in right now and I'm gonna capture all the smoke I can get. Can you still see me?
No.
I'm gonna capture all the smoke that I can get. Even when it's not on temperature, I need everything that I can get. But I'm not finished. If there's so much smoke, you can't see your steak anymore. So I have this device and I'm just gonna stick it in right now, straight in the middle, so I can keep track on it. I'm gonna close the lid and I'm gonna smoke it till it reaches a temperature of 54 degrees Celsius.
What are you doing?
Checking my health.
Dude.
I only walked up one stair today.
You're worried about that?
Yeah.
I think you should worry about the steak.
Why?
Is it done already? You think, what are your temperature are you cooking it to?
54.
54?
Yeah. I checked it, it's now 31.
But there's a pitfall in this recipe. This is a trick. This is a test. You can't just make assumptions here. You gotta think about the things you do. And I'm not telling you what the trick is, but you gotta think about it. Think about it.
Okay.
Don't screw it up.
Okay, don't screw it up, okay. Okay, let's take it out. I don't know what the pitfall is, but it's at 31 right now. And what I think that Roel is mentioning is that the frying process will cause so many heat to develop that if I go to 54 and then cool it off, it's gonna burn, it's going to be overcooked. So, that's hot. Don't forget that. When you're doing this at home, don't forget it. Oh man, that's hot. It's something around 32 right now. And I think that I just have to cool it down right now and go for the frying process. So what I have here is a frying pan. And it's a simple one. It's got a lid. It's got a basket. So what I'm using is a frying oil. And this is just regular frying oil. This is the thing that how does it open? And why is it on? I don't think this is supposed to be happening. That's weird.
Why is the fryer smoking?
I don't know. I think we just have to let it cool down for a minute. And then add frying oil. This is dangerous stuff. I would say this is pure gold, but it's not. It's just regular frying oil. I'm going to hook it up, set it to 180 degrees Celsius, and we'll wait. But we have another problem to tackle. Because this is a major problem. So I'm going to send shock ripples all over the cooking world. I'm going to do something terrible. If your children are watching this, send them away. It's going to be terrible, but I'm going to stuff it in. It doesn't fit, so you have to make it work. I'm not going to cut it. Oh, this is terrible. This is terrible. This is just horrible. This is horrible. Why do they make these steaks so big? Who comes up with these things? This is horrible. This looks horrible. I don't know what's going to happen, but it will come out pretty good. Pretty awesome, I hope. Because it's a Wagyu, it can't go wrong, right? Okay, here we go. Oh no. Oh, that's terrible. It might be a little bit full. I might overdid it a little bit. I was expecting that the steak would be a little bit smaller inside the frying pan. So just step aside. Step aside, Butch, don't worry. It's okay, right? It's frying.
This clip.
Yeah.
Right before.
Yeah.
I don't know what's gonna happen.
Okay, I'm gonna stand here. Ooh, that looks so awesome, man. Look at that color. That's insane. That's insane. So it works. It looks perfect, but we're not done yet. So we'll just let it continue. Relax. You know, I'm gonna sit with it. I'm not sure if I should sit so close, but no. It's gonna be fine. You know, the thing is, I would normally flip it, but there's no chance that I can move this in this basket and just flip it around. I kind of don't want to touch it. I gotta take it out right now. And how? I'm not sure. With a knife? Come on. Come on. But it looks beautiful. And it's a Wagyu. So there's a possibility that I screwed it up, but it's a Wagyu. It kind of does the work for me. The temperature varies from 56 to 54 to, well, I even see some spots that are at 70. I'm just gonna deal with it. I'm going to sprinkle on some salt. Just some nice finishing salt. And I wanna add some pepper. And because, well, mainly because Roel asked me to. It's his favorite. It's Peña pepper. It's just perfect for a steak. So normally you would sprinkle on salt on one side, but because we have beautiful pepper, I want to do the pepper on both sides. And now we'll wait. We'll just let it cool down and then we're going to slice into it.
You feel confident?
No.
Let's see what he made of it. First of all, great looking crust. Yeah. Love it.
But come on, you're frying it at 180 degrees Celsius. That's the easy part.
So I gotta check. Did you get the crust or not? You got a nice pink color, a little bit of gray on the outside, but that's okay. That comes with frying. That's the technique. Oh, look at that. So tender, it just falls apart. What do you expect with Wagyu, but come on. We gotta be real here. Just like, it almost falls off. That is one tasty steak. I haven't had Wagyu for 3 weeks. This is like...
Good job.
This is complaining on a high level. I've been missing out. This is a steak. And it is really, really good. You know, this is not easy to do. You cooked a steak.
I thought it was easy to do.
No, let me tell you, frying and smoking as a technique combined is one of the hardest things to do. You gotta configure or figure out a way how to get a nice smoke flavor and at the same time get a beautiful crust on the outside. You start throwing things?
Yeah.
We're gonna get hectic in here.
This is the star of the show, man.
Yeah. It looked simple in the beginning.
But you gave me that one tip.
I had to. I didn't want you to mess up the steak.
I would have been smoking it to a temperature of 54 degrees Celsius. What would happen if I let it cook to that temperature and then completely cool it off before I threw it in the fryer?
It will be overcooked. Right. But now you made like the perfect steak.
Come on, take a piece. That's a good crust.
That is a good crust.
Easy. We're gonna get your piece. It's Wagyu. It's A5. Don't eat my hand.
If you're not rolling with the white pan and pepper,
there's a really hungry cameraman. Over
you're not rolling at all. Yeah, you want to feed him?
I think we should feed him. Come on. Okay, it looks overcooked, but it's really good.
It's not overcooked. The only thing that I don't like about this steak is Morsen didn't put on enough smoked white pan and pepper.
Oh, we can fix that.
I already did. I got it right here on the board.
Oh, okay. Oh, wow.
You can tell Morsen that it's good.
Okay.
Otherwise, he thinks he's better than me.
Mm-hmm.
We can't have that.
I'll keep my mouth shut.
Yeah, I want to avoid the whole situation where he becomes like
the Netherlands. The next thing.
Yeah. He says you walk next to your shoes. That's so good. Did you dip though?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So if you want to cook steaks like Morsen, just go down to the link. It leads you to the website. There, it's exactly how to make this steak. Foolproof method, written down, pictures, everything. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. See you guys next time. Until
then.
No. Forgot the patrons.
Oh, yeah.
Big thanks to the patrons and
the YouTube members.
See you guys next time. Until then.
Eat smakelijk.
And keep on grilling.
Mmm. Really, really good.
Really, really good.
Really, really, really.
Very awesome.